Hi, I'm Rod. Welcome to my channel. Today I am listening to Smashing Pumpkins perform Bullet with Butterfly Wings. This is the official music video. So here we go.
The world is a vampire. Sent to drain. Secret destroyer.
Smashing Pumpkins with Bullet with Butterfly Wings. That's a great song. Yeah, it's really good. It's quite catchy, which makes it, and it's easy to sing along to, so I think that would help making it popular. The video seems to be representing maybe forced labour. I know he has said that the song had a strong personal presentation of how he felt at the time, particularly with his growing fame, and I think he was struggling with that. He may not have made things easy for himself because he was quite abrasive in interviews and things. I know they were getting a lot of shit from the indie bands at the time, calling them sellouts, and if I remember correctly, I think it was what's his name, Corgan, who, to paraphrase him, he said something like, when they were calling him a sellout and the Smashing Pumpkins a sellout, he more or less called them hypocrites and said that, you know, if you're selling tickets to your shows and if you're selling albums and you're selling shirts with your name on it, then you're commodifying your product, which is right. Well, at least I agree with that. All bands commodify those who have a product that is more desirable will get more out of it. He also said something like, this whole nonsense of these bands claiming that groups like the Smashing Pumpkins were sellouts is like raging against the machine or fighting against the machine with an iPhone, which I thought was good. I'm pretty sure it was Corgan that said that. Never really a big fan of Smashing Pumpkins, but they did cop a lot of shit that wasn't warranted, or at least I don't think it was. The indie groups and the punk groups like to call out others as sellouts, but at the end of the day, they're just hypocrites. You know, out of one side of their mouth, they're calling Iggy Pop a sellout for doing commercials, and out of the other side of their mouth, they're calling him the godfather of punk, somebody to be worshipped. I think this song touches on Corgan's frustration and anger, and his inability to change things. That he still doesn't seem to have the control over his life and over the band, his music, that he would like. That's a great intro where he straight out says, what is it, the world is a vampire, and then the music kicks in. I suspect in this case, the vampires are possibly the record executives, and I would say the fans as well. And you know, he goes on to about dealing with his growing celebrity status and him struggling to deal with that and the demands of the music business. He did once say too that if you knew about his childhood, you would understand the song, something along the lines that he grew up in a family that prepared him for failure. Not quite sure what he meant by that, whether they brought him up in a way that he was destined to fail, or whether they prepared him for dealing with failure. Not quite sure. But anyway, a bit about the band and the song. The Smashing Pumpkins, or simply Smashing Pumpkins, are an American alternative rock band from Chicago, Illinois, formed in 1988 by frontman and guitarist Billy Corgan, bassist D'arcy Wretzky, guitarist James Iha, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing either of those names correctly, the drummer Jimmy Chamberlin. The band has undergone several lineup changes since their reunion in 2006, with Corgan being the sole constant member since its inception. The current lineup features Corgan, Chamberlin, and Iha. Mellon Collie and the Infinite Sadness is the third studio album and first double album from Smashing Pumpkins, released in 1995. The lengthy 28-track album was released as a 2-disc CD and triple LP. The album features a wide array of musical styles, including art rock, grunge, alternative pop, and heavy metal. Bullet with Butterfly Wings is track 6, written by Billy Corgan. I think, I don't know, what I get from a bullet with butterfly wings is a bullet that really doesn't have any effect. And I think that would go along with the lines, despite all my rage, I'm still a rat in a cage. So for all his anger and, maybe some of his outbursts in media, if the media, at the end of the day, he's still a rat in a cage. He's still performing for the music business, for the fans. Nothing's changed. Anyway, I think this is a great song. This would be, if I was putting a list together of my all-time favorite songs, this would be on it. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did and you would like to support the channel, the best way you can do that is by liking, subscribing, and commenting. It all helps, and I hope to see you in another video soon. Thanks for watching.